For even the brightest riders, making their way onto the World Tour can be a challenge. This isn't truer than for life as an aspiring women's rider, and with just four junior European races on the calendar, every race counts. But having a Paris-Roubaix legend, national champion and Tour de France stage winner as a father, the Backstedts are not your typical family.
Emma was at Paris-Roubaix when I won it. She was only 3 years old, but she was there watching. So, and I think when I retired from the World Tour scene, I don't think they were really into the cycling and they hadn't really started looking at it in that way. It was kind of when I came back and ran the UK youth team for a couple of years and started racing on the British scene and did Tour of Britain, and they came along and watched that and watched it on television, and all of a sudden there was a bit of a wow, okay, Dad actually rode a bike and at a pretty high level.
I started riding when I was about four, but I started to proper get into it as I was like seven or eight, and I like maybe first year under 14s when I was like 12, 13, I really started to enjoy it after I broke my leg, so that really gave me the drive to push on and be really good. I always remember like going into the team buses and meeting all the riders, and just the atmosphere was really, really good. I remember more when he started like UK youth, and I just loved watching him race and like how he would ride. It was just really inspirational.
They grew up around bikes, both of them, and it was only a question of time before they really wanted a race bike for themselves, and we started going down to the Mainly Flyer sessions in Cardiff, and very, very quickly obviously we saw that there was quite a bit of talent there, and obviously it's a long way to go still, but that so far is still kind of moving on, and the talent is clearly showing. So, but for me, it's just providing the opportunities that they want to go after.
But Eleanor isn't the only daughter of a champion looking for success. Servais Knaven, also a winner of Paris-Roubaix and of a stage at the Tour de France, has a daughter already following in his footsteps. With Britta Knaven's confident GC win at the Omloop van Borselen.
I was pretty surprised that all my daughters wanted to go into cycling. They were not really interested for a long time. I stopped cycling when Brit was 10. And then they did their first race at my farewell race. They also had a race with on normal bikes. And then you could see that they liked it, but then they were still not interested. They were doing gymnastics. And then, yeah, out of the blue for us, Brit was into cycling. And from that moment, yeah, they all wanted to ride their bike. So, yeah, I had to buy four bikes and found out that it is a little bit more expensive than gymnastics. But yeah, the most important for us was like, yeah, they really enjoyed it. They went to the first training at the cycling club, and you could see it for them, it was like coming home.
I started cycling when I was 12 years old, and I did my first race when I was almost 13, so not a long time ago. No, I don't remember much of him racing because I wasn't that interested in cycling back then. But now I think I regret it a little bit that I wasn't that interested in his cycling back then.
Oh, I'm really getting much more nervous than when my kids are racing, especially, I have to say in the beginning I was of course most nervous, and it's getting a little bit less. But still, when like last week, when they're racing in Italy and we are home, you're super nervous. You have no information and just waiting for a live stream or whatever, or an update. And not nervous about the result, but more nervous that they stay on the bike and don't have a bad crash or something like that.
I never really got nervous when I was racing. Maybe at the very, very early stage of my career did I get nervous. And I still remember I got nervous on my first Tour de France start, like in Dublin. I was very nervous, but apart from that, I don't think it's ever been something that's kind of come into place. But yeah, sitting in the car, I do get nervous. You want them to do well, and you're wishing them to do well, and that goes for the whole team, you know. So it's not just Eleanor. We got a bunch of other girls that you know, you're investing emotional interest into and helping them out, and you know, doing things with coaching and so on and so on. So you're spending a lot of time really investing that energy into it, and of course you get nervous and excited, and you want them to just have a good race and be able to do the best that they can do without anything sort of getting in the way of that. It can be difficult watching, but at the same time, they're aware of the dangers in the sport, and I mean, Adam has been off the bike a number of times with broken collarbones and God knows what else. So they're aware of it as well, and I think you just have to take it for what it is and understand the dangers of the sport, and if this is what they want to do, then so be it. There's so many other dangerous things you could be doing in life anyway, so I don't have a problem with it.
Now both retired ex-professionals, and with Knaven being a Team Sky director sportif, both fathers have a plethora of knowledge that they're able to pass on to their daughters riding in the junior ranks.
They really enjoy that he gets to come and watch me, and hopefully he gets a bit excited when I'm doing well, and he just gives me support when I'm not doing so good or when my legs don't feel that well.
We're just more the most intense and really, really into it and really motivated. We talk a lot about cycling, Britt and me, and about training, and she's really interested in advice on training, tactics as well.
Yeah, sometimes he gives me tips, but I don't always listen to it. Sometimes I just go my own way, but I also take his tips and like mix it into my own.
He tries to pass down all the advice that he can, but I try sometimes to learn it for myself, and he'll just feed back to me what bits I could have changed or what I could do differently in certain situations. But I've learned so much from him, and it's really, really helped during racing.
He tells me almost every race that I just have to jump out of the peloton. Just ride really fast. Don't make it to a sprint, because I'm not that good of a sprinter. So if I want to win, then I will have to ride away from the peloton and finish solo.
I try and just let her get on with it, and when she needs to ask me a question about something, whether it's tactical or material, whatever, anything really, then I just try and back her up and help her out with the experience that I got.
I know that there's someone there that understands and that like can help me, and if I don't do so good, he doesn't tell me off, he doesn't get angry, he just helps me find a different way to do it, how to improve. So that for me is really, really important.
You've got to be very patient with that and let them sort of find their own way of riding and their own way of doing things, and try and understand that human being, not what I'm like or what my wife was like as a bike rider, but let's just let them develop into their own characters and riders effectively.
It is nice, of course, as a former bike rider, that your kids also like the same thing that you like to do. Of course, now it's even nicer for my kids, because I'm working in one of the best teams of the world, and I see a lot in professional cycling, and it's also nice for them to get a little bit from that.
I think Eleanor is probably a lot more like me. What you can't solve with power, you usually solve with a little bit more power. That's kind of always been her way of riding, and I think that was very similar to how I rode, especially very early on in my career. It was never really, you rode first and thought afterwards.
Hopefully one day I'll win Olympic gold. I'm not really sure what discipline yet, whether I want to stick to track, do road, do a bit both maybe, but yeah, maybe world champion too would be pretty nice.
Yeah, I would like to become a professional cyclist, but I'm also looking with my studies. I'm going to university next year. I'm just going to see how it goes, and I just really like it. So I hope I can make it to a professional cyclist.